Hey guys, Bobashik here, and today I want to talk about why Classic as a PvP-er, more specifically a specific PvP-er. I've been playing the game for 15 years, I've been playing Feral for over 9 years, never got the chance to play Druid in vanilla. I was a warrior back then, and I've only started playing Feral in Wrath of the Lich King, across the end of Season 7, start of Season 8, and yeah, since then I've been maining it, but yeah, I'm looking forward to Classic, how it was, how the hybrid class felt like back then, even though Feral wasn't the creator of specs. It seems like really exciting to like make it work, and looking at those other streamers and YouTube videos, it seems like a lot of fun if you like put the effort and time into it, even if you like playing casual. The reason I want to play Classic is like I like tryharding, you could say, but not the tryharding as it is like right now, going to deep dampening games just to win the game, or like facing people that just wanna play in deep dampening because it favors their comp to get the kill. I find it a bit dull. The tryharding in vanilla, I mean, is more getting that edge with engineering, playing your class to your full potential, like for with Druid from what I've seen, like rooting, Moonfire, Insect Swarm, going back to Cat, do some DPS, go Bear. The shape-shifting, warriors having the stance dancing, just utilizing your class to the full potential instead of sitting pressing like 3 buttons instead of like your whole arsenal of spells that you have at your disposal. This comes to the next thing, all the spells you have at your disposal, hybrid classes specifically. Looking at Druids now, I can cast a regrowth with my Predatory Swiftness on myself, I can use a Swiftment and I gain 30% HP by pressing those 2 buttons, and then I see a Fury Warrior just using his rotation gaining 20% to 30% of his HP by pressing that Bloodthirst. The class identity is like really far to search in my eyes. I want to feel that back. I hope it gives me that feeling again, because obviously the memories I have of vanilla are only the good ones. I do not remember all the struggles and the annoying moments, because that's just how memory works, I feel like. But yeah, the gearing. In phase 1 you have like the possibility to just spam dungeons and probably do Molten Core. And depending on what spec you are, a casual guild or a casual group with friends that you have, which I'm quite fortunate enough, like I have like 13 to 15 people going or saying they're going to play vanilla. So it should give me the possibility to make dungeon groups. I'm gonna be a feral tank, because tanks feel like a really rare thing. And it gives me the possibility to also DPS. But furthermore, even if you're like a hybrid spec of Feral and Restoration, with the right gear, which can be like Cloth, Intellect, Beast with Spirit and Spell Power and what the hell not, dungeons, healing dungeons should be like fairly doable. That's like another fun thing that you don't have to farm through all the Azerite traits and whatnot. Even while leveling, you can be a Feral Druid, just swap to the gear and you might actually be like decent at healing the dungeons. But yeah, what on next, on max level even? That's fairly hard to say, because it's really the private servers that I have seen playing Wars on Gods, they have like a million consumables at their disposal, million engineering bombs, and I don't feel like it's gonna be like that in Classic at all. I feel like even though BGs might be cross-realm from what I've read, which is a bit sad but understandable, because they don't know how big the PvP scene is going to be in Classic in the first place, and they want to make sure that people get queues when they queue up for one. Apart from that, you have to make a choice to like play with engineering or not. I would advise strongly if you're a PvPer to do it, because it gives you that extra edge, especially for classes that like Druid, that are quite dependent on like being versatile and adapt to every situation. Engineering is gonna help with that very greatly. But yeah, BGs being cross-realm, having a pre-made group obviously helps a lot, that you can coordinate your stuff. Having that feel that you work as a team to go to a win, because there's no timer, so it's all about the team playing together and winning the game, is something that like really satisfy me. Especially when I'm going to be playing Druid in Wars on Gods, flag carrying, doing those jumps, out kiting 5 to 8 people. It must feel amazing from what I've seen. Even looking at people's streams like StormX for example, it's something that I look really really forward to somewhat outplay the people or like put them on the wrong leg and then just being able to get away. But even like playing casually, like I said before, from dungeons, molten core, you'll have the base gear, just like everyone else if you're there from the start. You don't have to play hardcore, just spamming dungeons, mindlessly, okay, you'll have the gear faster. Excuse me. But BG's only come out in phase 3, so you have plenty of time to get like the pre-raid base, some molten core piece, some Blackmoon Lair pieces, and then you all start on the same foot. Some people will rank faster, obviously, but from what I remember, rank 8, which is like Legionnaire on Horde side, I do not recall the Alliance one, I'm sorry, I'm mostly a Horde player. Seems really doable by just playing like maybe 5 to 10 BGs and hopefully win them all each day. BGs can last long, don't get me wrong, like 1 BG can last for hours, but even if you do like 1 BG or 2 BGs per day, tops, it's like 2 hours of playtime, which is fair, like still quite a lot, but 7 days a week, 2 BGs and you win those BGs, then you should rank up decently. That's at least how I feel like about it. I don't know the exact time investment, it mostly depends on how fast your queues are and if you're like motivated to play a lot that day or not. But even the blue PvP set, which will be like scaled to like the end of vanilla how it was, so it will compete I think with Blackwing Lair gear, and High Warrior will compete with HQ40 gear if I'm not mistaken, which is like insanely good. So a casual PvPer can get the blue PvP set or even the Alteric Valley Unstoppable Force two-handed mace as a Feral Druid or Warrior. Even an Enhancement Shaman, for example, can use it. Seems like really good gear that like a casual PvPer could actually get. And who knows, maybe you get noticed by playing insanely well and you have the gear that they've asked you to join like a pre-made group and you just have to play like an evening a week to get your honor cap. Who knows? I'm not really that much of an expert in it on how hard it is to get high wallet these days or how hard it will be to get it these days. But definitely doable for a casual PvPer to just play the game. Even world PvP is gonna be like really fun. Like not everyone is gonna be PvPing obviously, and if you're like on a PvP realm, excuse me, just having the right dungeon gear, just play the game, have fun. It's always possible to like outplay people and just utilize your class. It's if you look at the license now on beta as well, people just being level 40, just ganking in the world and everything, just having the blast, the time of their life, using engineering, doing some clutch plays. Obviously the game has changed a lot BFA wise, but if you go back you'll see how it was originally, and even now it's not the vanilla from 15 years ago, because people just understand the game better, they understand the spells way better, you see so much in engineering stuff, but apart from that, people really think over their spells now on how to use what, like theory crafting and everything. I just look really forward to it, to like start thinking about every move I have to make and not doing my rotation, and maybe do some 1v2s and 1v3s. As you can see in the brawl right here as well, I picked this brawl because I love Warsong Gulch, and it's a nice thing that they put it in, that you can get 3 flags and then you have to make 10 caps. You'll see a cheeky 1v2 here as well, which is something I look forward to in vanilla as well. Will I be able to do it like this? Obviously not. I won't be able to sit cat form the whole time and whatnot. But yeah, like here I put full bleeds on the warrior. I'm gonna be rooting him in a second as well. He's bashed first, he trinkets out of it. And then I leap away. And then yeah, I mean, being able to do that, most satisfying ever. And now in this game it feels like it's almost not possible. Almost all classes are like the same. It's yeah, I don't know the exact word for it, even how I want to explain it. It's satisfying to 1v2, but it happens so little, even though you might be outplaying two people at the same time, like this as well. This Paladin just heals himself to full, fine, it's a hybrid class, like I can't really complain about that. But it's funny, like he didn't actually cast any healing whatsoever. But yeah, anyway, it's the gearing, doable, engineering, getting it, as soon as possible, kind of give you that small edge, even if you play a class that's like underrepresented, like Enhancement Shaman, Feral Druid. It's worth the shot, definitely. As a casual PvE-er, or PvP-er even, I would definitely advise to play it. And who knows, you like it. You might not get past level 10 or 20, so be it. But I would strongly suggest to like try out Classic. Maybe they'll realize, because we play it, that they have to change something about the game, like patch 8.2, and I think Ion said something about giving back some spells to mages, for example, that they can cast fire spells even though they're frost spec. It's a huge improvement. It seems like they're actually looking at how beta is evolving and how it can be done on live again on how it was in Classic. Having that spec identity back, but also being able to be versatile with your other spells that you have in other specs. Anyway, it maybe like sound like a bit of a ranting video, but I hope nonetheless that you enjoyed it. Just want to put it out there. I hope that Classic will be a success, and I hope I can still play the actual game at 120 and so on in the future. I will keep making videos of Feral Druid. Love the class for 9 years, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Bye bye.